3M, always curious about them. They had their earnings out. What happened?
So the stock is actually up this morning, which I think is really interesting. And I think that may be sort of a reflection of the sell-off we saw across industrials yesterday. We had that really disappointing showing from Caterpillar. But I don't necessarily think 3M's numbers are that great. So they're cutting 2019 guidance, cutting their outlook for organic sales growth this year. And the reason why that really sticks out to me is they just gave those targets in November. Mm. And analysts at the time thought that they were fairly aggressive, especially on the growth front, because they were essentially calling for stronger growth than what they saw in 2018. And what we've been hearing across the board is there is a slowdown coming, maybe not growth dropping off a cliff, but you're definitely losing momentum. So that was a forecast that never really made a lot of sense. Now they're walking that back. Why I think that's especially relevant is 3M has a new CEO. This is now, you know, this is not the first time he's had to walk guidance back. He's only been there since July.
What are the variables for them? And what drives their top line, and for that matter, their earnings the most? What's the biggest variant?
So, you know, 3M is a shorter cycle company, so they have fairly limited forward visibility. So that does play a role in terms of predicting forward guidance, forward sales growth. But, you know, some of the big drivers for them are the automotive markets, mm-hmm. the electronics markets. Those obviously have not really been areas of strength in the industrial sector right now. And so I think that's where you're seeing some of the weakness. They didn't really have a great, strong, you know, growth number in the consumer segment, which I think is sort of interesting, you know, just sort of given what we've seen in the retail sector.
I do think it is interesting that the stock is up so much, just based on like fourth quarter earnings actually being good, because everyone's saying it's about the outlook. They give the outlook, and then what happens?
Well, there's a little bit of a discrepancy too in their fourth quarter earnings number, and I want to find out more about this, but they seem to be factoring in gains from a divestiture, which is not typically how they've been reporting their earnings. So there seems to be a little bit of a definition change here that's playing into, you know, the degree of that outperformance. And then they also seem to be sort of changing the parameters around their guidance. So that may be a factor here.